Are they in the car?
We're in the car.
Did we leave them in the
car? We need a guy that knows this game, how to explain this game.
Hey, listen up, guys. But it can only be stolen twice, okay? So once it's stolen,
he knows what he's doing.
Merry Christmas. It's cocoa season. ASMR.
The brown paper bag with green and the white.
Oh.
Yo, Mav, get
he's
to work.
Knocked out, bro.
It is. Socks! Oh! 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 I'm not
top ramen
the socks.
Yeah, top ramen underwear.
What is it?
It's moving!
What is it?
I thought you smelled like it smelled now.
Oh! Oh,
he's dead!
Oh, he's dead!
It's dead!
What?
Is he dead?
He's dead! Don't shake it! He's sleeping!
Fishy! 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 Does anyone know CPS?
You're joking! Bro! Yo, we're at the media brain right now, dude! Yo, let's pray on this fish!
Let's lay hands on this fish!
But I'm gonna...
Wait, is that
pick what? Pick what?
Steal his canes.
Yeah. I'm taking your canes, dude.
Oh, you dude.
Chick-fil-A is trash. Canes all day.
Okay, what is it?
Yo!
If you have a gift, please hold it up. If it's stealable.
Everything's stealable.
He says what it's called.
Yes.
I got
it. Whoa! Taruka.
Get it, Kayla. Go, oh, Kayla. Go, Kayla. Kayla. Go, Kayla. Go, Kayla.
I'm so very sorry.
Oh, good job, I'm sorry. Go, Alexis.
That's all these.
Open it. Open it. You got it.
Sorry.
Oh, wait, does the bad include? McDonald's?
Wait,
open
the
package.
It's
a
this? A $15 gift card?
I thought it was an actual
meal. No, it's an actual
Happy Meal.
Yeah,
she has a fit now.
Yeah, you already have one on.
Yeah. She knows. Dude, what's your point? Wow. It looks better like this.
Okay, Daniel, I got you, bro. Okay. The best friend game. Yes.
You're my best friend.
Okay.
Best friends, bro.
So you,
I need friends, bro. I need friends.
Like he's last, right? Yeah. Dude, you can't lose, bro. That's it, man.
Guys, well, hey. So that concludes our gift wrapping. Thanks. So thankful you guys are here.
Christmas, only a hippopotamus.
What's up, Harvest Youth?
What is going on?
You're watching One Sip with Colton.
And Wyatt.
And we're out here trying to see what
peppermint mochas give us the best holiday cheer and which ones give us the most holiday fear.
And our first stop is Conjon Coffee. In fact, Jada actually made our drinks, which is pretty cool. She's one of our youth students. Yeah. And so, Jada, we love you, but also know that this is a serious competition here.
It's very serious.
And so we're gonna judge it hardcore. Okay, this is what you want. Cheers?
Cheers.
Cheers, let's do it. One sip.
One sip.
Give it a score, okay?
All right, let's do it. Let it go all the way over all the taste buds. Mm-hmm. It's decent.
Okay.
I think it's a little light on the peppermint, a little bit.
I would agree, okay.
It could use a little bit more, mm-hmm. but overall, it's got a nice little mocha flavor. It's not overpowering.
True that.
It's pretty good.
I like mochas. Oh, sorry.
No, go for it.
I was saying I like mochas that have like almost more of a dark chocolate flavor, and this mm-hmm. hits that. Like it isn't yeah. super sweet, which I appreciate. Like it's definitely yeah. got the little sweetness there, but I taste more like unsweet dark chocolate than it does like sugary syrup, which yeah, I definitely. Like really appreciate. I agree with you on the peppermint though. Mm-hmm. Like it's like a hint of peppermint. Like it's not like. Peppermint mocha.
It's not like grabbing you with peppermint.
It's like a mocha peppermint.
It's like an afterthought almost.
Yes.
Yeah.
But it's not overpowering, which
it's
I appreciate.
Not. It's pretty good.
Do you have a score on mine? Remember, like 10 is incredible.
10 is incredible.
Like 10 is like impossible. 8 is like incredible. 5 is like eh. And then like anything below like 4 is just.
I'm gonna give it like a 7.2.
A 7.2?
7.2.
I can't take another. I can. Brian just nodded at me. He said I can take another.
I'm gonna take another.
6.8. My socks aren't knocked off. It yeah. just tastes like, it's good.
Are your socks slipping?
They my slip socks off? Are slipping.
They're
for
slipping.
Sure.
Okay.
Yeah, they're slipping for sure, but they're just not off.
They're not off.
You know, I increased my score to a 7 because okay. the personal connection. That's
there. There you go.
Thanks, Jada, for the personal connection.
Cheers.
One sip. Okay. We just got our peppermint mochas from Coffee Bean and Tea Leaf. Not gonna lie, the wait was kind of brutal.
Wait was a little long.
I think we ordered at 12:15 and it is currently 12:25. So 10 minutes for a coffee?
10 minutes for a coffee is a little long.
I don't know, dude.
I don't know about
I understand
that.
They have a drive-thru and all that, but come on, dude. So we did order peppermint mochas. I'm gonna take the lid off on this one because let's just go ahead and analyze it. Not even from the sip standpoint, but no art.
No
it's
art.
Honestly, if we're talking like latte art or latte foam in general, the fact that it's that jiggly is really just not it.
It's like Santa's belly.
Cheers.
Cheers.
One sip. Or bigger, because sometimes raccoons just shat on the bottom. What's your thoughts?
It's pretty good. I like it.
Do you?
I do.
Why
I
do you like
do
it?
Like it. It's a lot. It's warmer than the previous ones.
I will say the temperature is good.
The temperature is much better than the previous one. I think the chocolate flavor is a little sweeter than Conjon's. I think there is a little bit more peppermint flavor to this one. So,
you get that?
I'm gonna take a second sip on this one.
Okay.
If that's all right.
Yeah. I'm gonna be brutal on this one. Personally, I feel like I'm drinking a chocolate milk. Not a peppermint mocha.
Okay.
I don't really taste the coffee in this. And that's like number one thing about a coffee drink is yes, there's syrups and yes, you're tasting the peppermint mocha-ness of it. But the fact that like I couldn't distinguish this from a hot chocolate.
That's true.
Is very disappointing for me as a coffee connoisseur. And then also, again, if we're gonna talk about this foam, this is unacceptable for a latte.
Foam's a little lacking. You ready to give it a score? You go first this time.
I will, wait, just before, sorry. The temperature is nice. The
temperature is very nice.
I will say this is a good latte temperature.
6.3.
3.9. Dude, 3.5.
Dang.
Wyatt, you enjoy coffee drinks.
I enjoy coffee drinks. I'm not like, I'll drink whatever. Like, I'm not super picky about everything, so.
I am like a coffee connoisseur. And so, like, I mean, I spend my time with my coffees, and I really, like, I've dedicated a lot of hours to making coffee and understanding it, and this is not it. I'm, like, Gordon Ramsay right now,
okay.
And you're, like, Martha Stewart. I feel bad throwing this away.
There, too. We got a lot more coffee to go coming up. Kind of set that in there nicely.
We just went to Starbucks. Wow, that table's not sturdy enough. We will say this is way faster than Coffee Bean.
Much faster.
We're at a 5 minute, no, 4 minutes?
Like four minutes
opposed to 10, so that's already good on my radar. Cup feeling pretty hot. Check, art check. Ooh, art okay, check. Okay.
There we
need
go.
A little bit of whipped cream and a little bit of mocha sprinkles.
Okay,
okay.
There we go.
That was a pleasant surprise.
Much better.
Much better.
Still a little jiggly.
A little jiggly, it's fine, it's fine, it's fine.
That's all right.
You know, I'm okay with like
whipped
cream.
What's wrong with a little jiggle?
All right, ready? Cheers.
Cheers.
One sip.
One sip.
Okay. That's significantly different.
Wow. That's much different than the last two.
That hits the peppermint mark.
Absolutely. The peppermint is like right in front. It's almost like punching you in the face.
Yes. And I get like the minty feel.
Yeah, definitely.
You know, like the fresh breath type-esque thing. And the chocolate still feels chocolate.
Chocolate's
I'm actually
fair.
Like pleasantly surprised
this is
right
really,
now.
This is actually pretty good. I
usually
like this one
loathe Starbucks, and this is like pretty decent. Not
see,
gonna lie.
I like this. I could finish this whole thing, I think.
I would definitely say that, like, Condron's still above this. Well, we'll get to the score in a second. But
yeah.
The peppermint is... This is by far the most pepperminty peppermint. Okay.
Most peppermint forward.
I love that language. I will say that, if we're going to embrace, like, grade this as a coffee drink, like, the coffee is definitely buried.
Oh, yeah.
But
I'm
it's there.
Like, no
it's,
coffee.
It's
almost.
Way... Yeah. But it's better than Coffee Bean. This tastes like a candy bar.
Yeah.
And I appreciate that. You know, if that's what you're looking for.
I'm not mad about it.
You know, it's fine.
It's pretty good.
You want to give it a score?
One last sip, hold on. 6.8.
I'm going to go with that too, actually.
Really?
Believe it or not, if you're looking for a sugary peppermint mocha drink,
this is it.
This is actually pretty good.
This is the
one. I'm not going to lie. I might do 6.8, 6.5.
Right in there.
Right in that range. I walked in expecting to be disappointed, and I walked out a little bit impressed, not gonna lie.
I really didn't know what to expect from Starbucks. I knew it was gonna be like a sweet drink kinda, but considering the last two were kinda lacking on the peppermint, I'm really glad this one has a lot of peppermint in it.
6.5, 6.8.
6.5, 6.8.
Who do we appreciate? There's a train. This is the last stop. Okay, first of all, the experience, incredible as always.
Wonderful.
Get a shot of this art for a second. That's a true barista work right there. That's
cool.
There
we go, perfect. Look at that.
I have high expectations. I'm also like kind of biased because I love arcade.
This is my first time here, so I have no expectations.
Cheers.
Cheers.
Let's do it.
One sip. That's really good. That's really good. I like that a lot.
It's his first time at arcade.
It is. I'm not my last.
I think this is exceptionally good.
I can definitely taste the coffee on this one a lot more. Peppermint's subtle, but it's there. You can notice it.
Yes. I think the peppermint comes in the back half.
It does. It comes afterwards, which is very nice. And then the mocha flavor is very present, and it's a little darker, but not too dark.
Yes.
It's like a... This one's really good. Like,
no,
it's like words can't describe it. I'm trying to, but it's like hard. It's just like I want to just enjoy it.
Yeah,
you know.
The if we're gonna talk about the drink, like fundamentally speaking, the foam, the milk, perfect. It's amazing. It's wonderful. Like that's like number one latte foam art. The coffee comes through in the first. I'd seen that the like there's three parts of this drink.
Absolutely.
Like and you taste each part in order. So like there's like the coffee part, but then you get that dark chocolate kind of tongue feel. And at the end, there's like that minty bite, which like makes it refreshing. Just look at that. Just art, it's still intact. That's good foam.
That's pretty. That's
good
spot
foam.
On right there.
I'm gonna throw a 9.1. That's a good peppermint mocha.
Okay. See, I was thinking 9.3.
Oh, he's like he's
this
over
is,
the moon.
I like this one a lot.
Hi.
Is this the Great. End? Should we wrap it up? Well, hey, you've watched one sip.
You've listened. You've experienced with us.
Now, what was the phrase you said in the beginning?
Which peppermint mochas are going to give us holiday cheer, and which ones are going to give us holiday fear? I'm definitely feeling cheery after this one.
Cheery. Cheers. So, cheers.
Cheers.
Cheers. Cheers.
Merry Christmas, everybody.
Merry Chrysler.
Merry Chrysler. We'll see you next year.
Hey, what's going on, everyone? It's Troy here, and Merry Christmas to you. Tomorrow is Christmas, yeah, because it's Christmas Eve. You know, around Christmas time, I always think of a story or a situation that happened in my life when I was younger. 2007, it was Christmas, and I had such a dramatic experience. Why? Because I was a little brat. All right. I was a little brat to my parents. I was in seventh grade. And around Christmas time, you know, I always desired to have the best gift, electronic based, you know, PlayStations, the Game Boys, playing Pokemon and things like that. And around 2007, I wanted not one, but two gaming systems. Yeah, that's right. Two gaming systems. I wanted the Xbox 360 to play Halo and the Wii. The Nintendo Wii, the first electronic gaming system that had motion sensors. And so I asked for those for Christmas. And, you know, when Christmas came, because I begged my family for this. When Christmas came, I opened up my gifts. And I had the Xbox 360. I had Halo. I had some of the other Xbox games that I asked for. But I couldn't find the Wii. Yeah, I couldn't find the Wii. So I was searching everywhere for it. I thought maybe I missed it under the tree, and then I asked my parents about that, and they said they didn't get it for me. And I was so upset. I was crying. And, you know, it's kind of like Dudley and Harry Potter. Yeah, that was me right there. And in this moment, my parents are like, no, we got it for you. It's somewhere in the house. But what my parents really saw was my heart in it all. You see, that year, probably like every single year before that, I lost sight of the true meaning of Christmas. You see, Christmas is not about the gifts that are underneath the tree. Christmas is about the true gift and the person that was hung upon that tree. In Luke 2, we are given an account of shepherds that were out in the dark, taking care of the sheep in the field. And late at night, the night that Jesus was born, an angel appeared to the shepherds and they were terrified. And the angel said, whoa, you don't have to be afraid. You don't have to fear, because the message that I bring you is a message of good news and of great joy that is for all people. The angel said that this is good news and that it will bring great joy. And this is why we can have good news that the shepherds received. And it's in Luke 2, verse 10 through 11. It says, I bring you good news that will bring great joy to all people. The Savior, yes, the Messiah, the Lord, has been born today in Bethlehem, the city of David. He gave three reasons. He said, the Savior has been born, the Messiah has been born, and the Lord has been born. First is the Savior. Savior means someone that can save or deliver someone from possible danger. The Messiah means anointed one. You know, Jesus Christ, his last name wasn't Christ. That means he was the anointed one or the Messiah. See, Jesus was the fulfillment of all of God's promises to the Jews. But also too, our Lord has been born. And Lord meant that he had authority. Jesus, the baby that was born in the manger, he had all of the authority in the whole entire world. And it wasn't in the place that brought him value where he was born at. It was in who he was. He was God in flesh. As we're going to open up presents tomorrow morning, I pray that you would be able to go out and tell people about the true gift in Jesus, because our Savior has been born. Our Messiah has been born, and our Lord has been born. With that, I just want to say God bless you and Merry Christmas.